Welcome to a lesson on how to create a histogram. A histogram, as shown below, is a bar graph that displays numerical data grouped into intervals called bins. We have the intervals or bins listed along the horizontal axis. The bins are 0 to 2, 3 to 5, 6 to 8, 9 to 11. Each bar represents the frequency or number of data points that fall within each interval. The frequency for the first bin 0 to 2 is 5. The frequency for the second bin 3 to 5 is 7, and so on. Another important characteristic about a histogram is that the bars should always touch. A histogram is used to show shape, spread, and center of a data set. And now let's create a histogram from the given data below. We have the number of books read by students over a summer. The first step is to determine the bins or interval width. All the widths must be the same. Here we have four bins, 0 to 2, 3 to 5, 6 to 8, 9 to 11. Also notice there's no gap in the intervals. And now we'll tally the data to determine the frequency. For the bins 0 to 2, we have 1, 0, we have 2 1s, and then 3 2s. 1, 2, 3. The frequency is 6 for the first bin. Next, for 3 to 5, we have 2 3s, 2 4s, and 2 5s. The frequency is 6. For the bins 6 to 8, we have 2 6s, 2 7s, and 1 8. The frequency is 5. For 9 to 11, we have 1 9 and 2 10s. The frequency is 3. Now we create the histogram from this completed frequency table. For the first step, we set up the horizontal axis, which will contain the intervals or bins. And then we set up the vertical axis with the frequency, which represents the number of students. For the bin 0 to 2, the frequency is 6. The bar has a height of 6. For the bin 3 to 5, the frequency is also 6. The bar has the same height and no spaces between the two bars. For the bin 6 to 8, the frequency is 5. The bar has a height of 5. And for 9 to 11, the frequency is 3. The bar has height 3. And now we have our completed histogram. Before we go, I've also provided an analysis of the data in the table below. We've covered all these topics in previous lessons. You may want to pause the video and review these statistics. I hope you found this helpful.